Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today in this video we are going to make this 3D flower square pattern in which we have made a 3D flower in a granny square. This square can be used for making baby blankets, bedspread, for table runner and so forth and so on. So we are going to begin now. Things that we require for the project are yarn of two colors. The choice of colors depends on you. A pair of scissors to use as and when required, and a hook that could match to the thickness of the yarn. So let's begin. To begin the pattern, take the tail of the yarn, make a loop, pull through the loop. This is slip knot. Now yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. These are four chains. We have to go back to the first one, insert the hook in, pull through. There are two loops on the hook, pull through two. This is slip stitch. Now foundation ring is ready. We have to make a chain, and now into the ring we have to make 8 single crochet. So insert the hook in, pull through. There are two loops, pull through two. This is single crochet. Insert the hook into the ring, pull through two loops, two. Insert the hook in, pull through two loops, three, four, five, six, 7 and 8. So these are 8 single crochet. Now we have to insert the hook into the first chain, pull through. There are two loops on the hook, pull through two. So this is slip stitch. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, and these chains are count as a double crochet. Yarn over, into the same loop, pull through. There are three loops on the hook, pull through two, pull through two. This is double crochet. Yarn over, insert the hook into the same stitch, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. Yarn over, into the same stitch, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. Yarn over, into the same stitch, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. So these are 5 double crochet. Now we have to turn the pattern. Chain 1, 2, 3, yarn over, into the next stitch, insert the hook in, pull through two, pull through two. Yarn over, into the next stitch, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. Yarn over, into the next stitch, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. Yarn over, into the chains, into the third one, pull through two, pull through two. Now we have to turn the pattern again. Chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now we have to put these chains behind the petal and into the next single crochet. Insert the hook in and join the stitches with slip stitch. Now chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, yarn over, into the same stitch, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. So these are 2 double crochet. We have to make 3 more. So yarn over, pull through, pull through two, pull through two, yarn over, pull through, pull through two, pull through two, yarn over, pull through, pull through two, pull through two. So these are 5 double crochet. Now we have to turn the pattern, chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet. Now insert the hook into the next stitch, pull through 2, yarn over into the next stitch, pull through 2, yarn over into the very next stitch, pull through 2, yarn over into the very next stitch, pull through 2. Now we have to turn the pattern again, chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, put these chains behind. Now we have to insert the hook into the next single crochet, pull through 2. These two petals are ready. Now we are going to make one more. 1, 2, 3 chains. Into the same stitch we have to make 4 double crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4. Turn the pattern. Again we have to start with 3 chains. 1, 2, 3. Now into the next stitch we have to make a double crochet. Into the very next stitch, 1 double crochet. Into the next stitch, a double crochet. And into the next stitch we have to make a double crochet. Again we have to turn the pattern and now chain 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Put these chains behind the petal into the very next single crochet. Insert the hook in, pull through 2. This is slip stitch. Now you have to make 5 more petals to complete this flower using the same method. Now we have completed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 petals of the flower and these are 6 chains. We have to put them behind and we have to tie these stitches into this slip stitch with a slip stitch. Now we have to cut the yarn from here and now we are going to add another color of yarn to the pattern. From the back the flower would look like this and from the front it is here. Now we are going to add color B to the pattern. So to add the color we have to insert the hook in, pull through loop. This is slip stitch. Now we have to add this yarn into this chain space with a slip stitch. Now we have to make chain 1, 2. Now into the next chain space, yarn over, pull through 2, pull through 2. So this is 1 double crochet, 2 and 3. So we have to make 3 double crochet. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3. Again into the same chain space we have to make 3 double crochet because we are going to make the circle into the square. So this is one corner of the square. Now chain 1, 2. Into the next chain space we have to insert the hook in and a slip stitch. Again chain 1, 2. Into the next chain space we have to make double crochet 1, 2, 3, chain 1, 2, 3, yarn over, double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Again we have to make chain 1, 2 for chain space. Into the next chain space we have to join these stitches with a slip stitch. Now chain 1, 2 again. Into the next chain space we have to make double crochet 1, 2, 3, chain 1, 2, 3, double crochet 1, 2, 3, now chain 1, 2. Into the next chain space, we have to join these stitches with a slip stitch. Chain 1, 2 for chain space. Into the next chain space, we have to make 3 double crochet again for the corner. 2, 3. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3. Again into the same chain space, we have to make 3 double crochet. 1, 2, 3. And now chain 1, 2 for chain space. Now we have come to where we have started. We have to join these stitches with slip stitch. So one round is complete, and now we have made the circle into a square. Now into this stitch we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet. Into the chain space of 2, we have to make double crochet 1 and double crochet 2. On the top of these 3 double crochet, we have to make double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Now into this chain space of 3, we have to make double crochet 1, double crochet 2, chain 1, 2, 3. And again 2 double crochet, 1, 2. On the top of next 3 double crochet, we have to make 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3. Into the chain space of 2, we have to make 2 double crochet, 1, 2. Now where we have made a slip stitch, we have to make a double crochet on the top of it and 2 double crochet into the chain space of 2. Now we have reached the next corner where we have to make 3 double crochet on the top of 3, 1, 2, 3. Now into the chain space of 3, we have to make 2 double crochet. And again we have to make 3 chains and 2 double crochet again. 1, 2. Again on the top of next 3 double crochet, we have to make 3 double crochet. 1, 2, 3. Into the chain space of 2, we have to make 2 double crochet. Into the single crochet, we have to make a double crochet, and into the chain space of 2, we have to make 2 double crochet. We have reached the next corner where we have to make 3 double crochet on the top of 3, 1, 2, 3. Into the chain space of 3, we have to make 2 double crochet, 1, 2. Chain 1, 2, 3, and again we have to make 2 double crochet for the corner of the square. So complete the round following the same pattern. You have to complete 1.5 round more. When the round is complete, we have to join these stitches into the third chain of the fourth stitch with a slip stitch. Now we have to make chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, and chain 1 for chain space. We have to skip a stitch. Into the next stitch, we have to make a double crochet. Chain 1, skip a stitch. Into the next stitch, we have to make a double crochet. Chain 1 for chain space, skip a stitch. Into the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch into the chain space of 3, we have to make 2 double crochet, chain 1, 2, 3, and 2 double crochet again, 1, 2, chain 1 for chain space, skip a stitch to the next stitch, we have to make a double crochet, chain 1 for chain space, skip a stitch into the next stitch, a double crochet. Now chain 1 for chain space, yarn over, skip a stitch into the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1 for chain space, skip a stitch into the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch into the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch into the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, and now we have to make 2 double crochet into the chain space of 3 for the corner, chain 1, 2, 3 again, and into the chain space of 3 we have to make 2 more double crochet for the corner of the square. Now chain 1 for chain space, skip a stitch and into the next stitch, a double crochet, chain 1, skip a stitch into the next stitch, a double crochet. So complete the round following the same pattern. After the end of the round, we have to join the stitches into the third chain of the first stitch with a slip stitch. Now we have to make a single crochet into the chain space of 1. Insert the hook in, pull through 2, a single crochet on the top of double crochet, a single crochet into the chain space of 1. We have to make single crochet across the square in this round. Again, on the top of double crochet, a single crochet, on the top of double crochet, single crochet 1, into the chain space we have to make 1, 2, 3, 4 single crochet, on the top of double crochet, single crochet 1, on the top of double crochet, a stitch into the chain space of 1, 1 single crochet, and on the top of double crochet we have to make a stitch. So this is how we are doing single crochet on all the stitches of this side of the square. In the same way, we have to complete the round by making single crochet on all the stitches below to complete this square. Now we have come to the next corner of the square. Into the chain space of 3 we have to make 1, 2, 3, 4 single crochet, and on the top of 2 double crochet we have to make 2 single crochet, into the chain space of 1, 1 single crochet, and on the top of double crochet a single crochet. So complete the round following the same pattern. After the end of the square we have to cut the yarn from here, and now one square is complete. We can make as many squares as we require for the blanket, for the bed throw, or for the table runner. But this time we are going to make a table mat, so we are going to make 3 more squares for table mat. This is how we have completed 4 granny square for table mats. We just have to join these squares all together to complete the pattern. We can make blankets, baby blankets, table runner and more with these squares. If you like this pattern, try one for yourself. Thank you so much.